Maraming salamat po at magandang umaga sa inyong lahat. Isang lunti ang umaga sa ating lahat. Isang makakalikasang araw sa pagalawang araw ng inyong makabuluhang pagtutulong ng mga dakilang foresters ng ating bansa. Ako'y namamangha na makaharap kayo ngayong araw na ito. Bagamat ang mga naging sa akin ay mga makatali kong kaibigan, advisors at consultants, ay hindi ko akalain na ganitong karami ang magdadalog sa inyong Society of Auditors ngayon. Ako'y hihingi ng paumanhin dahil ako'y bedroom voice, dahil sa pagkasipag ko siguro ay hinahamon ko pati na ang kalikasan, maski na sobrang ulan at hangin ay nagsasagawa kami ng mga climate change hearing noong isang araw, 2 days ago. Yung dating mga palayan sa Santa Cruz, Laguna, Talima, ng mga magsasaka, ngayon, parte na ng lawa ng Laguna, yung mga taga Laguna, alam nila yan, at yung rex lang sa UPLB na hectares and hectares, hundreds of hectares of land in the province of Laguna and Rizal are now part of the lake because of the more than 2.5 meters increased elevation of Laguna de Bay because of excessive rainfall and because of increased siltation and sedimentation. Ako'y natatakot magsalita sa harap ninyo dahil ako'y naman hindi scientifico. Ako naman ay hindi IPCC. Ako naman ay hindi doctorate. Ako lang ay firm advocate and passionate environmentalist. Yun lang po ang aking pagkakamalito. Ang sabi ko si Derex at kay Mr. Rueda at ang aking mga si Dr. John Pulhin at si Marlo na kaninang bumati sa akin sa entrance at yung representante ni Mayor Lim, si Attorney Sofia. Ay sino ba naman ako para magbigay ng mensahe sa mga magagaling na mga foresters? Eh kayo ang aking mga consultants and advisors. In fact, the recently enacted Climate Change Act would probably not have been as perfect as I'd like to see it were it not for the inputs of several of our great Filipino scientists, namely Dean Rex Cruz, palakpakan natin, Dr. Velasco, who's abroad now, Dr. John Pulhin, and Dean Vicky Espaldon also helped us, and Dr. Ino Lansigan, Dr. Rosa Perez of PMO, sila Marlo, at ang dami-dami tumulong sa paggawa ng Climate Change Act. Hindi lang po Nora Legarda yan. Aaminin ko, no, ako yung unang nahalala, yung pangalawang nahalala ng July 2007, my dream was to have a Climate Change Act. Honestly, it was not a refined bill. It was an original bill, literally based on a dream. I woke up after the campaign of 07 and I said, I want to have a Climate Change Act. Ikit-painit ako sa ibang bansa na handang-handa sa pag-akma o adaptation sa pagbabago ng klima. Tayo, kung hindi, pag walang bahala, ay mababa ang kaalaman. Lahat ng kausapin ko, mga kasama ko sa Senado, without casting aspersion on them, whenever I stand on the floor, on climate change speeches and environment and low carbon growth, etc. That's the time they would go out to smoke or go to the lounge to eat, and then they would nod their head and say, ayun na naman si Loren, climate change na naman. Ayun na naman si Loren, lumiti ang Pilipinas na naman. Ayun na naman si Loren, environment na naman. But now, I'm happy to know that not only my colleagues in the Senate and in Congress, but also teachers from Binagat Island, from Masbate, from Tawi-Tawi, students and public elementary school students, everyone are asking now for copies of my speeches, copies of documents and research studies, copies of the Climate Change Act, of my solid waste management law, of some of the documentaries I've done on the environment. It is far from perfect because I am not an expert. But all I can say is that I will be an unrelenting and passionate advocate like you for the environment. Thank you, Mr. Renato Berueda, Presidente po ng Kayong Society Foresters, for this invitation. I will repeat, I feel humbled to be in your presence because you are the foresters, you are the scientists, you are the experts. You teach me, and I, as Dean Rex Cruz knows, I am a good and diligent student. In fact, marami sa mga tinuturo ni Dean Rex at ni Dr. Lasco at ni Dean Vicky, parang, I always say parang, styrofoam, I absorb it. I absorb it very fast. In the beginning of my term, they've been giving me lectures in Nicholas Banos and Dr. John Pugin, and I love listening to them. And earlier, Mr. Derueda asked me, how is your campaign going? I said, what campaign? I don't intend to campaign because honestly, even after 12 years in politics, I'm not a politician, despite you considering me a politician. And I told him, I don't intend to campaign because this is a thing I'd like to do. I like to be in the midst of environmentalists. I like to be in the midst of foresters. I like to continue my climate change hearings to bring it down to community and barangay level. I want to see the full implementation of my Solid Waste Management Act, RA9003, way back in January 2001, which is only 13% compliance. I want to see the IRR implementation of the Climate Change Act 2 weeks ago signed by the President. I want to see the funding of the Climate Change Act and the creation of the Commission and to make sure the right people and a forester will be there in the Commission. A forester coming from the society, huh? Yes. And I want to make sure that all of these are into place. And I said, that's the kind of campaign I will be waging. Because the campaign we need to do now is the campaign against poverty and hunger and joblessness and climate change. It's not a political campaign against political parties or political opponents, but really the campaign of the Filipino people and the people of the world against changing climate brought about by our ignorance, our apathy, our abuse of nature. But I don't have to preach to the converted because, as I said, you are the experts, I am here an advocate. I would like to make a special mention of my colleague of 25 years ago, that ages me, who was the foremost newscaster when I was still a student. It ages him, Joe Carlos. I was a trainee of UP Mascom, and he was the number one newscaster, very handsome up to now. And I would, why are you laughing? And I would be an intern at RPN9, and I would try to walk in front of them, had Gasser and Joe Carlos, para lang mapansin ako. I was a 19, 20-year-old Mascom student waiting to be discovered by television. And I'm glad they took a second look and discovered me. Because if I did not enter broadcasting, I probably would have been a forester. Because my being an environmentalist was probably going to be.